Okay, so before I get into this video, this video is about wells water or spring water. In this case, these are spring waters. And yes, we drove about 30 minutes just to go to the spring to get these. There is a website. I'll leave it in the link or in the description. You can actually find out where a spring close to you. We see people driving all over the place for them. The one that we go to. And yes, we take about 10 of these every time we go. And it lasts us about months. And then sometimes if we don't, like in the winter, we have to buy them. Not buy from these, but buy regular water. And then we save the jugs for it, and in the summer we go. Although the spring that we go to, it's running 24/7, even in the winter. It doesn't freeze up or anything, because it's constant running. So when you get a chance, check this website out, and you'll be able to find out where all the springs are. People post them. Make sure to ask questions. Make sure to ask things before you actually even go there. Okay? But for us, this is where we go. And this is how we get our water. And it's awesome. But remember, even if it's wells water or spring water, these are the steps that you have to take, and these are the steps to make your wells water and spring water even better for your body. And it's very simple. Okay? So I'm going to teach you how to do it. Okay, so after we get our water, what would you do to them? Well, if you follow that journey in up here, my water journey, you will understand why we need to do things like this. And if you look at it, this one here, the cap is still on. Why? Why? It's because we have not let it out yet. It's still stuck. Remember, I talk about in my water journey, is that radiation, the decay radiation, it takes a long time for it to escape, including gas. Now, if you look at this one, there's a bunch of bubbles in here. Why is that? There's no difference between this and this. And yes, you can do this by yourself and you will see it. Why is that? It's because the gas is eventually leaving because it has enough room now. See it? So the more the room, the more it will escape. And then eventually, you just, during the day or something, you just lift this up. Or open up your bottle. Like that. Same thing with this. Okay? So, to make a habit, or to speed up things faster, when you get your water, you lift this out. Okay? You open that. That way all the gas will escape. How long? Usually? Depending on how much it is in there, but usually for a 5 gallon, 2 to 3 days. And once you do that, you drink from it. Okay, I did this on purpose. So that way, we can learn from that. You can see a bunch of bubbles in here. There's no bubbles in here. Because I haven't released it yet. When it comes down to the earth, there's gases, there is electromagnetic, there is what they call radiation decays, because it's in the earth, blah, 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 blah. So when you take it out of the earth, or in this case, out of a spring or your well, That's what you gotta do. You have to release these gases. Then you drink from it. So then it doesn't bother your stomach. It doesn't, it actually helps you too. Mm-hmm. So there's many benefits just by doing this. It's easy as that. Leave your water for 3 days before you actually drink it. Leave it open just like this. Lift it open, right? Sorry, I have to make two hands there. Leave it open just like this and leave the cap up like this. Okay? And let it escape. Another way you can do, take a cup like this, put a bunch of holes on the side here, and flop it up like this. Bunch of holes here, the gas will escape out of it, and nothing will fall inside. Okay? It's easy as that. Drill a bunch of holes in the side, drop it in just like that. Mm-hmm. This will actually make your water healthier. Uh-huh. Amazingly as that, as easy as that. And yes, I do this all the time. Oh, storage. Do not leave it direct sunlight. Okay? Never. Never direct sunlight. You want it in the dark. Okay? So if anyone who teaches you to leave water in the sun, no. Never drink the water from the sun. Why? UV light will attack this. And before I go, my water journey is right up here. I'll link it right to here. Okay? That way you can learn from it. That way you know why we're doing all this stuff. Okay? Other than that, that's about it on this video. I will see you in the next video.